One, that she decided to take out a loan herself, $5 million of her personal fortune, something the Clintons are not used to doing, in part because they've never had this much money. And also, breaking late today on time.com, the fact that some of her senior staff have agreed to work without pay. Now, that's a smaller amount of money, but in that way, it's more significant. The fact that she's so strapped for money that they're going to do without their paychecks for a month shows symbolically and substantively how dire things are for her on the fundraising front. He can raise money on the internet every day, about $1 million, it seems, and she has maxed out, tapped out all of her donors and has not been anything like the sensation on the web. He also, the other big advantage I'd say he has besides his message, which is about change, which is the mood of the electorate, is the calendar in February really favors him the rest of the way. Number of states voting starting this weekend through the end of the month, they're almost all good Obama states demographically because their demographic support is pretty evenly cleaved. Young people are for him. African Americans are for him. High-income Democrats are for him. Independents are for him. All of those will be playing big in the states that are about to vote.
How do you see it?
I think pretty close. I mean, I think pretty close to Mark. I think I'm not sure to go as far as the convention, but I see no soon end to the fight between Clinton and Obama. I think they're so evenly matched in so many ways, and the delegate rules make it very hard for them to pull one or the other to pull ahead because all the delegates are allocated proportionally, and they're just within 30 or 40 delegates of each other right now. So. I think on the Republican side, I don't see how McCain at this point loses the nomination absent some sort of external event. I think that really one of the big stories yesterday was that Romney was, you know, if not mortally wounded, extremely wounded by how poorly he did. And that even though Huckabee won a bunch of states, I'm not sure what the long-term significance of that is, except for the fact that there's discomfort with the candidates and the social conservatives in the South.
You asked about the war room. I think in the Obama strategy room, one thing they have to be concerned about is they've now made two tries at the Hispanic vote in important states. In Las Vegas, they tried very hard. In California, they tried very hard. Spanish language ads, events geared towards Hispanics, prominent Hispanic supporters, and they did not break through. If you're looking for vulnerabilities on his side, it's in Texas in March. When if he does not do better with Hispanics in Texas than he did in California, I think he's in trouble there. And she may be able to pick up a lot more.
So what delegates does he have to do?
Join us online at charlierose.com.